Okay, students, today we will start the rest part of the chapter. So first is the vitamin. In the previous class, we have already discussed about the nutrients, carbohydrate, protein and fat. Now it is vitamin. Our body also requires another kind of compound, which is vitamin, for proper functioning and good health. So it means that for our good health, vitamin is necessary. However, these are required by the body in minute quantities. It means vitamin is essential for our body, and it is required, but in very small quantity. In addition to keeping our eyes, skin, bones, mouth, etc., healthy vitamins also protect our body from diseases. So, it means that vitamins not only protect our different parts of our body, also protect our body against different diseases. Absence or deficiency of vitamin in our regular diet result in disease, which is called deficiency disease. It means, if we do not take sufficient amount of vitamin or in our food, such kind of vitamins are absent, then we are affected by several kind of diseases, and these diseases are called deficiency diseases. Okay. Now, kinds of vitamin. Vitamins are of different types: vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin K, and another group of vitamin is called vitamin B. It means that vitamin A, B, C, D, E, K, they are individual vitamin, but vitamin B group is of many types, such as vitamin B12, B6, and particularly they are known as vitamin B complex. Here is the term, vitamin B complex. Each and every vitamin has different functions in our body. Vitamin A function for our skin and eye. It means that if in our food there is deficiency of vitamin A, what will be result? It affects our eyes and skin diseases occur. Vitamin B means group of vitamin, which helps in proper functioning of nerves and muscles. Means it makes healthy of our nervous system and also developed our muscular system. Vitamin C, it functions, keeps blood vessels, teeth and gums healthy, heals cuts and injuries. So it means that if in our food there is deficiency of vitamin C, what will be the result? There may be a teeth problem, gums problem, blood may release from gums. If we have a cut or any kind of injury, this injury does not recover soon, and the vitamin D makes our bone and teeth strong. So if there is a deficiency of vitamin D in a food, what will be the result? Our bones are poorly developed or not so strong. Not only bones, teeth also, they become weak. So these are the kinds of vitamin and they have the respective functions. So all kinds of vitamins are very necessary for our proper growth development, because they protect our body also. Now we have to know that in which food item these particular vitamins are present. It means that if we have to take vitamin A, we have to eat papaya, milk, mango, carrot. For vitamin B, all kinds of green vegetables, eggs, milk, whole cereals. These are the sources of vitamin B. Vitamin C means the fruits, mainly orange, tomato, lemon, guava, these foods. And vitamin D, the main source of vitamin D is milk. Beside milk, butter, eggs, fish. So, to take particular kind of vitamin, we have to take these food items. So these are the sources of each vitamin. ओके नाउ मिनरल्स. ओके सो प्रोटीन कार्बोहाइड्रेट फैट विटामिन्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट दिस न्यूट्रिएंट्स. नाउ अनदर न्यूट्रिएंट्स इज मिनरल्स. इट इज ऑल्सो न्यूट्रिएंट्स बट रिक्वायर्ड इन आवर बॉडी इन ऑल्सो वेरी स्मॉल क्वांटिटी. नाउ वी हैव अ क्वेश्चन दैट व्हाट आर द मिनरल्स. एक्चुअली दीज आर द केमिकल्स. कैल्शियम, आयरन, पोटासियम, सोडियम, मैग्नीशियम, क्लोरीन, दीज आर द मिनरल्स. दे लाइक विटामिन्स. दीज मिनरल्स आर ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ फूड्स. ओके सॉरी स्टूडेंट्स, देर मे बी अ कॉल. ओके सो कैल्शियम, आयरन, पोटासियम, मैग्नीशियम, क्लोरीन, दीज आर द मिनरल्स एंड दे आर ऑल्सो वेरी एसेंशियल फॉर आवर प्रॉपर ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द बॉडी. एंड दीज मिनरल्स आर ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ फूड. सो टूडे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड फर्स्ट विटामिन, डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ विटामिन एंड वेयर वी गेट दिस पर्टिकुलर विटामिन, मीन्स द सोर्सेस ऑफ द विटामिन एंड एट लास्ट मिनरल्स. नाउ वी हैव टू नो द फंक्शंस. फर्स्ट फॉस्फरस, इट्स फंक्शन इज दैट इट मेक्स आवर बोन्स एंड टीथ स्ट्रांग. कैल्शियम मीन्स हेल्प्स इन क्लॉटिंग ऑफ ब्लड, बिल्ड्स स्ट्रांग बोन्स एंड टीथ. सो फॉस्फरस एंड कैल्शियम बोथ टू मिनरल्स आर नेसेसरी फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ बोन्स एंड टीथ. बट नाउ क्वेश्चन इज दैट क्लॉटिंग ऑफ ब्लड. क्लॉटिंग ऑफ ब्लड मीन्स वेन वी हैव अ wound or suppose some parts of our body become cuts, so bleeding starts, but after sometimes the bleeding is stopped and the liquid of the blood becomes thick and ultimately the bleeding is stopped. This thickening of the blood at last after some times of bleeding, this is called blood coagulation or clotting of blood. So if in our food, in our body, there is deficiency of calcium, their blood coagulation process or clotting of blood does not occur. So what will happen if there will be a cut or any kind of injury, bleeding does not stopped. So if bleeding not stopped, what will be the result? Our body loses all the blood, or many of much of the blood is losses. This is harmful for our body. So for this, blood coagulation or clotting of blood is necessary, and calcium minerals helps in this clotting of blood. Now iron. Iron forms the blood, and iodine prevents goiter. Goiter is actually a disease which is caused due to deficiency of iodine. In the next class, what is goiter? We will explain it. Okay, so students, now we have to know the sources of the minerals. For example, calcium present in milk and eggs, potassium, dal and fish, iron in all green vegetables, leafy vegetables means spinach or other saag, apple. Sodium and chlorine present in common salt. Phosphorus present in banana and milk. Iodine present in fish and the iodized salt that are available in the market. So these are the sources of different kinds of minerals. Okay, just like vitamins, we have to memorize the different kinds of minerals and the respective sources. And at last, we have discussed that goiter, a disease which is caused due to deficiency of iodine. Goiter means is a disease in which glands of neck become swollen. We have found that many people's the neck region becomes swollen. Suppose this is the neck region, it becomes swollen and become puffy. These are the symptom of goiter disease. Okay.
Now, roughage. What is roughage? Undigestible fibrous food material is known as roughage. It is an important part of our food. It helps in proper functioning of the digestive system. Roughage does not provide any nutrients to our body. Plant products contain cellulose, which is a kind of roughage. So, like protein, vitamin, minerals, roughage is not a kind of nutrients, but it is essential. Why? Because it helps in the digestion, proper digestion of the food. After eating, it helps in digestion. All plant products contain cellulose. Cellulose is present in our food item, plant food, which is a kind of roughage. Actually, it helps in the smooth movement of waste, keep our digestive system normal, and prevents constipation. So, to prevent constipation, roughage is essential. It passes the food items within the digestive system so smoothly due to the presence of roughage. Apple, orange, pear, cabbage, they contain high amount of roughage. Roughage retains water in the body by absorbing it in large quantity. So it means that roughage dissolves water in our body through absorbing it in large quantity. So it's not give us, it not have any nutrient value. Or in absence of roughage, there doesn't occur any kind of diseases. But roughage is essential. Why? Because it is essential for proper functioning of our digestive system. And another thing is that it prevents the constipation problem. So roughage is essential. Those who have constipation problem, so they have to take more apple, orange, cabbage, this flour, these kind of food items which contain the cellulose. Means fibrous food. They have to take more fibrous food to prevent the constipation problem. So these are the roughage. This is roughage. And last is the water. We all know that water is essential for our survival. Because the food items that we take as a food, our body absorbs all these food items, means all these nutrients, through water. Because means water helps to absorb these nutrients to our body. It keeps our skin smooth, body cool and healthy, glowing. But sometimes excess water is also removed from our body in the form of urine and sweat. In the summertime, sweating occurs. We also get water through milk, tea, juices, different kind of curry, vegetables also. But if excessive water removed from our body, it may cause dehydration and it is very dangerous for our life. Death may also occur. So water is very essential for our body. The main function of water is that it makes our body cool, helps in glowing of our skin, and removal of wastes also occurs through water. The waste materials of our body passes out from our body in the form of urine, sweat. So water is a medium for transportation. Okay.